Hello students, now we will move towards the next kingdom. After the completion of kingdom Protista, the detailed classification of kingdom Protista we have completed in the previous video. Now the last kingdom is remaining, that is kingdom Mycota. So kingdom Mycota means what? So as the Mycota is nothing but this group consists of all fungi. So all fungal members are included under kingdom Mycota. According to R.H. Whitaker, the five kingdom classification, it was proposed by him, and this is the one of the group which is included under five kingdom classification, that is Mycota. So let us understand some of the most important silent features or general features of a kingdom Mycota. Yes, let us start. First, the characteristic feature of kingdom Mycota. As we know, all fungi, they look like a plant, but they are not plants. And why they are not plants? They look like plants because they are heterotrophic. They are heterotrophic. The term heterotrophic means what? The term heterotrophic refers to the mode of nutrition is hetero, means they draw the nutrition from the other organism. Next, they are multicellular. Their body is multicellular, made up of many cells, except one organism, one fungi, that is yeast. Yeast is a unicellular fungi. And next, their organization, their body organization is how? Their body organization is filamentous form. Filamentous means thread-like. Filamentous means thread-like structure or hair-like structure. And apart from that, if you see their organization, body organization, as I told you, they are very smooth, elongated, slender. Slender means smooth, long, thread-like structure. They are thread-like structure. That the thread-like structure is called hypha. The plant body is called as hypha. So such a group of hyphae, they are joined together to form a mycelium. The plant body, their body is called as mycelium. How the mycelium is formed? By the aggregation of hyphae. Hypha is a plural word, hypha is a singular word. Such number of hyphae grouped together to form a structure called mycelium. So I have not written here mycelium, but mycelium is a structure produced by a plant body. Next, with reference to their occurrence, where they are found? They are found in a moist place. They are found in a moist place where plenty of moisture is there. In such moist condition, they are growing. Apart from that, not only moist condition, where wet place is there, and the habitat they require is warm place. So warm place of even in the air, water, soil. So in the soil, if moist place is there they grow. In the water also they grow, and even in the air also they grow, because the moist as well as warm place, they promote the growth of the luxuriant growth of the fungi. Next, with reference to their cell wall, so they are also consist of cell wall. Like plants, they also have cell wall. So the composition of the cell wall is not cellulose, but their composition cell wall is chitin material, chitin or chitin. Okay, next. In addition to that, their mode of nutrition is heterotroph, already I told you, but heterotrophic mode of nutrition is further divided into saprophytic, parasitic. Saprophytic means they draw the nutrition from dead and decaying matter, the dead and decomposition material, they draw the nutrition. And some of the fungi, they draw the nutrition from a living host, from the living host. So thus, they may be either parasitic form or they may be saprophytic form. And there are some, very rarely, some fungal members are there where they are leading their life as a symbiotic association. Best example is lichens. So lichens, what are lichens? The algal and fungal association. The fungal filament and algal member, both are associated with each other, and they lead their life as a symbiotic association. So some, they lead their life as a symbiotic association. And as I told, their body is called mycelium. But the mycelium is, it may be branched, it may be unbranched. So this is one diagram. You can see the diagram. How it is? It is unbranched. And the nature of the mycelium is, as you can see, the number of nuclei are there. This condition is called as cenocytic condition. The hyphae are either cenocytic. Cenocytic means they do not have cross walls, means multinucleate condition. So each hypha consists of many nuclei, multinucleate condition we see in the mycelium, and that condition is called as cenocytic. And there are some mycelia which are septate. Septa means cross walls, you can see. So these are called cross walls. The presence of cross walls are the characteristic feature of a septate. Septate means cross walls. Cenocytic means no cross walls. There is no cross walls in the cenocytic. With reference to the reproduction, they reproduce by these three different methods. First one is vegetatively, second one is asexually, and third one is sexually. So they follow vegetative method of reproduction, that is by fragmentation. So what is the meaning of fragmentation? Fragmentation means that is the thallus or the filament is going to divide into number of pieces. The filament is going to divide into number of fragments, that is called as fragmentation. And second one is fission. Fission means they divide, some fungi divide into two equal parts, and each individual grow as an independent fungi. Then also by means of bud. So where we see bud formation, in case of yeast, the bud formation takes place. By budding also they reproduce. So these three are the vegetative method of reproduction. Finally, asexual reproduction. So asexual means without the involvement of the sex. So what are the asexual reproductive structures? The asexual reproductive structures either may be conidia or may be zoospores. Conidia are the asexual reproductive spores, as well as some fungi produce zoospores. So zoospores or conidia are the asexual reproducing spores. They germinate on the suitable moist place and they give rise to new mycelium. Thus they reproduce asexually by these two. Last one is sexual method. So as sexual means the involvement of the sex, the gametes are going to form, and here the sexual reproduction takes place by means of oospores, ascospores, basidiospores. So we are going to learn more about the oospores, ascospores, basidiospores, and how they are going to reproduce and germinate and give rise to new mycelium. The detailed process of reproduction you will be learning in the next video or subsequent videos. So these are the some of the general features, silent features of kingdom Mycota. So this is very important from the examination point of view. Okay, we will stop here.